فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. In the explanation of the book أسماء الصحابة التي اتفق فيها محمد بن إسماعيل البخاري ومسلم بن الحجاج بن مسلم القشيري رحمهم الله تعالى ومن فرد به كل واحد منهما دون صاحبه. That is the explanation of the book in which we will be إذن الله الكريم going through. We've spoken in the introduction about the book and the methodology of the author and the attribution of this book to him. Al-Imam al-Dharqutni rahimahullah, Al-Hafidh Abi al-Hasan Ali ibn Umar al-Dharqutni. So we're going to inshallah ta'ala start the book, go through it bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. The book doesn't require a lot of explanation. It's names, so we're going to read more of the names inshallah. And inshallah ta'ala, which of those, remember we mentioned there are three levels of how he brings the companions. Inshallah ta'ala, we're going to mention them bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. The author started by saying, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Or the nasikh, the one who brought the book out, he said this. قال الشيخ الحافظ أبو الحسن علي بن عمر الدارقطني رحمه الله هذه أسماء الصحابة التي اتفق فيها محمد بن مسلم محمد بن إسماعيل البخاري ومسلم بن الحجاج بن مسلم القشيري رحمهم الله تعالى ومن فرد به كل واحد منهما دون صاحبه اتفق في محمد بن مسلمة رضي الله تعالى عنه. So they all agree upon who? The first of them is Muhammad ibn Maslama radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This companion, Muhammad ibn Maslama, Bukhari and Muslim, they all agree on him. In other words, you find him in Sahih al-Bukhari, you know, find him in Sahih Muslim radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now we're going to start alphabetically now. Alphabetically, the author goes into the book. So the Bab al-Alif, and then Bab, and then Ta, and then Tha, and etc. We're going like that, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. اتفقا, they both agreed upon Bukhari and Muslim, في أسامة بن زيد بن حارثة. They agreed upon أسامة بن زيد بن حارثة. وأنس بن مالك وأبي بن كعب وأسيد بن حضير وأسلم أبو رافع. So the author goes أسلم أبو رافع. Grammatically it was right for him to say what? وأسلم أبي رافع. Instead of saying أبو رافع. والأشعث بن قيس وأسماء بنت أبي بكر. That's what they agreed upon. وانفرد مسلم بن الحجاج, but Muslim is singular in something, which is بأبي أمامة بن ثعلبة الحارثي, and his name is what? إياس. وبالأغر المزني, and also who? أغر المزني. أغر المزني, also somebody he left out was who? Somebody who he left out that Muslim was singular in is أسماء بنت عميس. أسماء بنت عميس, he left it out. Also, he left out Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. Who is what? Is in Bukhari and Muslim. Very good. نعم. وانفرد البخاري, and also Bukhari is singular in who? بأهبان ابن أوس وإياس ابن البكير. أهبان ابن أوس and إياس ابن البكير. نعم. أهبان ابن أوس, الإمام البخاري رحمه الله, he did not bring him in his musnad. He did not bring it في مسنده شيئا. It's not musnad. Rather is what? He brought it وأخرج. He brought it out من فعله موقوفا عليه. موقوف. He brings the موقوف عليه. And he's from the what? And he is from Uhban ibn Aws, he's from Ashab al-Shajara. لَقَدَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذُ بَايَعُونَكَ تَحْتَ الشَّجَرَةِ وَإِيَاسِ ibn al-Bukhayr. And also who? إِيَاسِ ibn al-Bukhayr. Bukhari didn't bring him min musnadihi. He didn't bring him in his musnad. Not at all. And he was a badriyan. كان من أهل البدر. إِيَاسِ ibn al-Bukhayr was أهل البدر. Ba. Now we finished Alif. But now moving on to Ba. اتَّفَقَ فِي بُرَيْدَةِ ibn al-Husayb al-Aslami. So they all agree, Bukhari and Muslim both agree on who? Buraydah ibn al-Husayb al-Aslami. Wal-Bara ibn Azib al-Ansari. Wabilal ibn Rabah. So you find those in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. Wanfarad al-Bukhari bil-Bara ibn Malik. We have Bukhari rahimahullah who is singular in what? Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah is singular. Al-Bara ibn Malik. But Muslim did bring him in his Sahih.
He does.
He does bring him in his Sahih. But he brings him in what? في قصة الملاعنة. And Imam Muslim brings him في قصة الملاعنة. In the story of the Anas ibn Malik رضي الله تعالى عنه. Remember what did he say? Anas ibn Malik, قصة الملاعنة, you know, Hilal ibn Umayyah. When he mentioned his wife, she committed zina with who? بشريك ابن سحمان. شريك ابن سحماء. He said that she committed zina with him. Then he goes and says, Imam Malik said, Imam Muslim رحمه الله said, وكان أخ البراء ابن مالك الأمي. شريك ابن سحماء was the brother of براء ابن مالك from his mother's side. Meaning they had the same mom. So that's how he brought him in there. And Al-Imam al-Darqutni is saying that Bukhari brought Al-Bara ibn Malik in his Sahih. Laysa bi Sahih. It's not right. Because he's not in Sahih al-Bukhari. Al-Bara ibn Malik is not in there. There's no mentioning of him. لذلك Al-Imam Abu Walid al-Baji, he says, ذكر أبو الحسن الدارقطني أن البخاري انفرد بالإخراج عن البراء ابن مالك ولم أرى له في الكتاب ذكرا. Al-Imam Abu Walid al-Baji says, Abu al-Hassan al-Darqutni, Al-Imam al-Darqutni, he mentions that Bukhari was singular in narrating from Al-Bara ibn Malik. وَلَمْ أَرَى لَهُ I have not seen, he's mentioning in his Sahih. لَا مُسْنَدًا وَلَا مَوْقُوفًا None of it. Muslim does like it. خَرَّجَ مُسْلِم Now we're going to go to Ta' now, we finished Ba. خَرَّجَ مُسْلِم Al-Imam Muslim narrated from عَنْ تَمِيم الدَّارِي حَدِيثَ النَّصِيحَةَ أبو رقية تميم بن أوس الداري أبو رقية تميم بن أوس الداري تميم الداري He is the one who narrated الدين النصيحة قلنا لمن قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم صحيح؟ Imam Muslim brings him and he's the only one who mentioned him Bukhari didn't وأبي رفاعة تميم بن أسيد العدوي You can say Usaid if you want to, and you can say Asid if you want to. Al-Adwi. وَيُقَالُ Asid, as Darqutni says. وَقِيلَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ ibn al-Harith. And others said, his name is Abdullah ibn al-Harith. Very good. We finished Tha. We're now going to move into Tha. انفرد مسلم بإخراج ثوبان مولى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم Muslim is singular in narrating from ثوبان مولى رسول الله the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم slave boy وانفرد البخاري بثابت ابن قيس ابن الشماس and also Bukhari was singular in narrating from who ثابت ابن قيس ابن الشماس ابن الشماس نعم واتفقا and they both agreed upon في إخراج ثابت بن الضحاك both of them narrated from who ثابت بن الضحاك وانفرد البخاري بثعلبة ابن أبي مالك خرج له حديثا عن قيس بن سعد and also Bukhari is alone on who ثعلبة ابن أبي مالك he narrated from him خرج له حديثا عن قيس بن سعد he narrated from him a hadith through Qais ibn Sa'ad. Through who? Qais ibn Sa'ad. Qais ibn Sa'ad, his suhba, whether he's a companion or not, is mukhtalafun fihi. This is khilaf on it. لذلك الإمام البخاري رحمه الله he never narrated from him in his musnad. الإمام البخاري he narrated him through who? He narrated him through who did I say? قيس بن سعد, right? No. I mean الإمام ثعلبة ابن أبي مالك, sorry. ثعلبة ابن أبي مالك his صحبة is مختلف فيه, is different upon. ولذلك الإمام البخاري رحمه الله did not bring him out في مسنده شيئا. He didn't bring him in his مسند. الإمام البخاري in his صحيح he didn't bring him مسنده. When he did bring him, he brought him through the رواية of who? عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه. And also قيس بن سعد. So he went through عمر رضي الله عنه and also قيس بن سعد. And دارقطني considered him بثعلبة ابن أبي مالك, he considered him to be what? في التابعين الثقات. نعم. رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. جيم now. We're going to now move on to جيم. اتفقا في أبي ذر جند بن جنادة الغفاري. They both agree upon Bukhari and Muslim, both narrate from أبي ذر جند بن جنادة الغفاري. Also, جندب بن سفيان البجلي وجبير بن مطعم وجرير بن عبد الله البجلي وجابر بن سمرة وجابر بن عبد الله وجرهم ويقال جرثم أبي ثعلبة الخشني وجويرية بنت الحارثة. They all agree upon that together, all of them, Bukhari and Muslim. They agree upon who? أبي ذر جندب بن جنادة الغفاري وجند بن سفيان البجلي وجبير بن مطعم وجرير بن عبد الله البجلي وجابر بن سمرة وجابر بن عبد الله وجرهم ويقال جرثم أبي ثعلبة الخشني وجويرية بنت الحارث. They all agree upon it. They agree upon each other on that. وخرج مسلم دون البخاري جدامة بنت وهب. Muslim narrated from جدامة بنت وهب. Who Bukhari didn't. Bukhari didn't. نعم. We're now going to move on to Ha. Sorry. We done Jim. We're now going to move on to Ha. اتفقا في إخراج حكيم بن حزام. They both agree upon narrating from who? حكيم بن حزام. وحذيفة ابن اليمان. والحارث ابن الربعي أبي قتادة. They also agree upon together narrating from الحارث ابن الربعي أبي قتادة. وحارثة ابن وهب الخزاعي وحفصة بنت عمر ابن الخطاب وحسان ابن ثابت. They will both of them narrate from these. وانفرد مسلم went singular on who? بحذيفة ابن أسيد أبي سريحة الغفاري وبحميل ابن بصرة أبي بصرة الغفاري. أن الحارث ابن عوف أبي قتا أبي واقد الليثي. نعم. الحارث بن عوف أبي واقد الليثي. أبي واقد الليثي أبي واقد الليثي has البخاري as well. نعم الحارث بن عوف أبي واقد الليثي هذا الرواية إن صحيح البخاري. نعم the hadith of sitting in the masjid. أبي واقد الليثي he narrated it. نعم شيمام الدار قطني must have forgot it. وبحنظلة الكاتب وبحمزة ابن عمرو الأسلمي. الإمام البخاري رحمه الله also narrated from him. حمزة ابن عمر الأسلمي. If you go to كتاب الكفالة in صحيح البخاري أول of it you find it that he narrated from him. نعم. Very good. وانفرد البخاري بإخراج الحكم ابن عمر الغفاري Bukhari went singular in narrating from who? Al-Hakam ibn Amr al-Ghifari. Wabi Hamz ibn Abi Wahb. Hamz ibn Abi Wahb. Sorry, Hazan ibn Abi Wahb. Hazan ibn Abi Wahb. We finished that one now. اتفقا في إخراج. Now we're going to move on to خاء. اتفقا, they agreed upon في إخراج خباب بن الأرت وخالد بن زيد أبي أيوب الأنصاري وخالد بن الوليد وخولة بنت حكيم. They both agreed upon narrating from these. The question here is خولة بنت حكيم. الإمام أبو وليد الباجي, when he was talking about the biography here, he says ذكر الشيخ أبو الحسن دار قدس is talking about أنهما اتفقا على الإخراج عنها. أبو خالد المسلم both narrated from who? خولة بنت حكيم. And he says the truth of the matter is there isn't. بخاري رحمه الله he did not narrate from her, لا مسندة, and nor has he narrated from her any of her روايات ولا من روايتها شيئا. Are you with me? And she's from the woman who gave herself to the Prophet ﷺ, who wanted the Prophet to marry her. That's what she wanted. She came to the Prophet and said, Ya Rasulullah, get married to me. She's from those التي وهبت نفسها للنبي. She's from those who gave herself to the Prophet ﷺ and said, Ya Rasulullah, get married to me. وانفرد مسلم بخفاف ابن إيماء ابن رحضة وخزيمة ابن ثابت. Muslim went singular in narrating from who? خفاف ابن إيماء ابن رخصة ابن رح ابن رحضة وخزيمة ابن ثابت. Both ways you can say, if you want to, you can say رحضة or you can say رخصة. Muslim رحمه الله singular in narrating from her. الإمام ابن حجر رحمه الله in كتاب التهذيب الكمال, which was written by who? أبو الحجاج المزي. He did استدراك on المزي on this issue رحمه الله, which is who? خزيمة ابن ثابت. وخزيمة ابن ثابت رضي الله تعالى عنه. وانفرد البخاري والبخاري وانسجل عن وات بخولة بنت ثامر وخنساء بنت خدام ذال. أخرج مسلم دون البخاري ذؤيبا والد قبيصة بن ذؤيب. إمام مسلم narrated from who? ذؤيبا, who is the father of who? قصي, from the father of قبيصة ابن ذؤيب. He's his father. That's ذال. را اتفق في رفاعة ابن عبد المنذر أبي لبابة ورافع ابن خديج وربيع سوري بنت معوذ ابن عفراء ورملة أم حبيبة بنت أبي سفيان. So they both agree upon in را رفاعة ابن عبد المنذر أبي لبابة. The second one was ورافع ابن خديج. The third one is ربيع بنت معوذ ابن عفراء. And والله she's one of the women who described the Prophet ﷺ and the way he looked عليه الصلاة والسلام شمائل المحمدية. ورملة أم حبيبة بنت أبي سفيان. وانفرد البخاري بخاري became alone in narrating from who? برافع ابن المعلى أبي سعيد and who? وبرفاعة ابن رافع الزرقي. بخاري and Muslim both didn't narrate from him. رافع ابن المعلى أبي سعيد. Are you with me? And who? رفاعة ابن رافع الزرقي. That Muslim, Bukhari only narrated from. Muslim narrated from only who? رافع ابن عمرو الغفاري. And who? وربيعة Ibn Ka'ab al-Aslami, and who also Rumaysa Sulaym. And later he's going to correct himself that Imam al-Darqutni later when he comes to the chapter of Babu Nisa al-Mukannayat, when he brings to the kunya of the women, he's going to mention that Rumaysa Sulaym is from Fima Tafaqa alayhi Shaykhan, that which Bukhari and Muslim both narrated from. And also Abu Walid al-Baji also done istidraq on him here in his kitab. He mentions ذكر الشيخ أبو الحسن أن مسلما انفرد بالإخراج عن الرميصاء أم سليم. He says that he claimed this. But then when it comes to Babu Kuna Nisa, when we come to the chapter of the kunya of the women, he's going to do istidraq of himself, Al-Imam al-Nasa'i Al-Imam al-Darqutni, and mention that they both, Bukhari and Muslim, both of them narrated from her. Wallahu a'lam. We're now going to move on to Azza'. اتفق في إخراج زيد بن ثابت وزيد بن أرقم وزيد بن سهل أبي طلحة وزيد بن خالد الجهني والزبير بن العوام وزينب بنت أم سلمة. زينب بنت أم سلمة. نعم. الإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله, he mentions that زينب بنت أم سلمة, she's rather from the تابعين الثقات, whose riwayat are in Sahihain. Because the majority of her riwayat, if you look at it, she's actually narrated from companions. If you look at the majority of her riwayat. And some of the scholars, they say, لا, قد ثبتت لها الصحبة. She was actually a companion. نعم. And if you go to Bukhari and Muslim, you're going to actually find a narration where she attributes to the Prophet directly, alayhi salatu wasalam. Naam. So, laha suhba, inshaAllah ta'ala. She's a female companion. وَزَيْنَبْ بِنْتِ جَحْشْ وَزَيْنَبْ الثَّقَافِيَّةِ إِمْرَأَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ بْنِ مَسْعُودِ. The wife of who? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. And Zaynab binti Jahsh, the Prophet's wife. Those are in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. وانفرد مسلم بزيد بن الخطاب وزهير بن عمر. الإمام مسلم رحمه الله, he became singular in who? بزيد بن الخطاب. And زيد بن الخطاب is the brother of who? عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه. But I think the correct opinion is that Al-Imam Bukhari narrated from him as well. وزهير بن عمر وانفرد البخاري and Bukhari became alone in بزاهر الأسلمي, who is the father of who? Majra'ah ibn Zahir, who is the father of who? Majza'ah ibn Zahir. Seen. Ittafaqa fi Sahl ibn Sa'ad al-Sa'idi wa Sahl ibn Hulayf wa Sahl ibn Abi Hathma wa Salman al-Farisi wa Salamat ibn al-Akwa' wa Sa'ib ibn Yazid wa Samurat ibn Jundub wa Sufyan ibn Abi Zuhayr والسبيعة الأسلمية وسلمان ابن الصرد وسلمان ابن الصرد. They agreed upon Bukhari and Muslim. وانفرد مسلم and Muslim became alone on بسبرة ابن معبد وسعد ابن معاذ. سعد ابن معاذ. الإمام البخاري رحمه الله narrated from him as well. So it's not mean the narrations that Muslims alone in. Naam. There's a mention of him in what? There's a mention of him in Sahih al-Bukhari, rahimahullah. Imam al-Bukhari brings in hadith 3950. Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, through Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Naam. And he also narrated from him before that as well, 3732. From the Musaf of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu ta'ala. So there is a mention of him in Bukhari as well. وَسَمُرَهْ إِبْنُ مِعْبَرْ أَمَا مِعْيَرْ أَبِي مَحْذُورَ أَبِي مَحْذُورَةَ سَمُرَهْ إِبْنُ مِعْيَرْ أَبِي مَحْذُورَةَ وَسُفْيَانِ بْنَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ الثَّقَافِيُّ وَسُوَيْدِ بْنُ مُقَرٍّ وَسَفِينَةَ مَوْلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَاتَّفَقَا they all both agree upon سَعَدِ بْنَ أَبِي وَقَاسْ وَسَعَدِ بْنُ مَالِكَ أَبِي سَعِيدٍ الْخُضْرِي وسعيد بن زيد بن عمرو بن نفيل. They all agree upon all of that. Bukhari and Muslim. وانفرد البخاري الإمام البخاري was alone on what? بسلمان بن عامر الضبي وسويد بن النعمان وسلمة الجرمي والد عمرو. He's a parent of who? عمرو. نعم. والسنين أبي جميلة وسالم مولى أبي حذيفة. سالم مولى أبي حذيفة. ذكره في حديث عبد الله بن عمر. He mentions him in the hadith of عبد الله بن عمر. وقد قيل إن سالما لما إن وقد قيل it was said إن سالما رأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. It was said that Salim saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم himself. It was said. So there's an issue here. If we say he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the question is, did he narrate from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? وسودة بنت زمعة. And سودة بنت زمعة is also that which Imam al-Bukhari was alone on. He was the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She's in Sahih Muslim by mention. This is Hafwa from the Sheikh. Sheen. Infarad al-Bukhari bi Shaybah bin Uthman. Now we're going to move on to Sheen. Infarad al-Bukhari bi Shaybah ibn Uthman. Bukhari is alone on it. Bi Shaybah ibn Uthman. Wa infarad Muslimun bi Shareed ibn Suwayd al-Thaqafi. Shareed ibn Suwayd al-Thaqafi, Muslim is alone on. But they both agree upon who? Shaddad ibn Aws. Saad. اتفقا they both agree upon who? Bukhari Muslim. في أبي أمامة صدي بن عجلان وصهيب بن سنان وأبي سفيان صخر بن حرب وصفية بنت حيي بن أخطب. The word حيي is a تصغير of حي. نعم. وانفرد مسلم بصفوان بن أمية الجمحي. Now we're going to go into those who Imam Muslim is alone on. صفوان ابن أمية الجمحي والصعب ابن جثامة الصعب ابن جثامة الصعب ابن جثامة. You know his brother. He's the man who came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He came to the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام and he said, يا رسول الله, he killed a man. He killed a man. And when he killed the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, When he killed the man, he came to the Prophet and said, Ya Rasulullah, istaghfir li. Ask Allah's forgiveness for me. And the Prophet looked at him and said, La ghafar Allahu lak. May Allah not forgive for you. In another riwayah, the Prophet said, Allahumma la taghfir. Allah, oh Allah, don't forgive him. And guess what? He went, the man, he became emotional, he cried, and he died. When he died, the companions, they buried him. When they buried him, the earth spit him out. So they buried him again. The earth spat him out again. They buried him again. And this time they said, maybe there's an enemy that's bringing him out of the earth. We're going to have to protect him. Just so we don't. And whilst they were looking, the earth spat him out. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this earth has swallowed people who are worse than him. It kept people who are worse than him. But it threw him out. And Allah did not do that except to show you guys. The reason is because he killed a Muslim. Spilling the blood of a believer. Killing an innocent person. Nah, it's not a joke. So, and the hadith is Hassan. The hadith is, it is Hassan. وانفرد البخاري بإخراج صفية بنت شيبة. Bukhari, he's single in bringing out the narration of who? The narration of Safiya bint Shayba. وهو في الأحاديث التي تعد فيها أخرجه من المراسيل وليس بصحيح رؤيتها للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم واختلف في ذلك. Bukhari is singular in who? Safiya binti Shayba. وهو في الأحاديث and it's in the narration التي تعد فيها the narrations which are considered that he brought it in his sahih من المراسيل that are mursals that are not from his conditions Bukhari رحمه الله وليس بصحيح رؤيتها للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and they are not from the narrations that we can say oh this is a sahabiyah who narrated from the prophet no because there's a difference between scholars are differing upon her suhbah if she's a tabi'i then her riwayat are going to be what? Mursal And a mursal is what? Min aqsam al-da'if, sahih? It's inqita'u al-sanad. The chain of narration is disconnected. Na'am. And Imam Abu Walid al-Baji quoted Daraqutni on this. Badruddin al-Ayni in his kitab Ubdatul al-Qari. The kalam of Imam Daraqutni bi-hurufi, word for word, they transmitted that statement. Even if you look at Qadi al-Iyad in his kitab Mashariq al-Anwar, al-Mizzi in his Tahdhib al-Kamal, al-Dhahabi Sir al-Aminu, Ibn Hajar al-Fath al-Bari, Even in his tahdib and his taqrib, Abu Zur'a ibn the son of al-Iraqi, in his kitab Tuhfatul Tahsil, they all wrote that. The statement of his. And Daraqutni considered her to be from what? He considered her to be from the tabi'iyin, who were thiqatih, the reliable ones, mimman sahhat riwayatu fi sahihayn, that are in. The reason why he mentioned her here, is to point that point out, to mention that point. Because there is a khilaf regarding her, whether she's a companion or not. There's a khilaf. So this was Saad, right? He missed Dad now. There's a person who could have brought with what? Al-Dahak ibn Qays al-Fihri, who Bukhari and Muslim both narrated from. طأ نعم اتفقا في إخراج طلحة ابن عبيد الله طلحة ابن عبيد الله they both agreed upon طأ نعم وانفرد مسلم بن الحجاج بطارق ابن أشيم ابن أبي مالك الأزجعي عن طارق ابن أشيم ابن أبي مالك الأزجعي الإمام مسلم is alone on نعم Scholars have actually critiqued Al-Imam Daraqutni on this one, which they said that Tariq ibn Ashyam, not the son of Abi Malik al-Azja'i. No, it's not. Are you there? So instead of the word bin, the correct is what? Abi. And just get rid of it. ضاء اتفق في ظهير بن رافع they both agree بخاري ومسلم on ظهير بن رافع عين they both agreed upon the narration of عبد الله بن عثمان who's he who's عبد الله بن عثمان نعم it's أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه وفي عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنهم وعثمان بن عفان وعلي بن أبي طالب وعبد الرحمن بن عوف وعبد الله بن عباس وعبد الله بن جعفر بن أبي طالب وعبد الله بن عمر وعبد الله بن مسعود وعبد الله بن الزبير بن العوام وعبد الله بن سلام وعبد الله بن زيد بن عاصم وعبد الله بن مغفل وعبد الله بن بحينة وعبد الله بن أبي أوفى وعبد الله بن بصر وعبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص وعبد الله بن قيس أبي موسى الأشعري وعبد الرحمن ابن سمرة وعبد الرحمن ابن أبي بكر الصديق وعبد الرحمن ابن أبزة عبد الرحمن ابن أبزة وعبد الرحمن ابن سعد remember عبد الرحمن ابن أبزة ابن أبزة الإمام مسلم رحمه الله he didn't bring him مسند الشيعة he didn't bring in his مسند فيتجت له وعبد الرحمن ابن سعد ابن سعد أبي حميد الساعدي وأبو هريرة الدوسي واسمه عبد وعبادة ابن الصامت وعامر ابن ربيعة والعباس ابن عبد المطلب but why من باب الفائدة remember the alif al-lam is what it's معرف right it's used for a word that's نكرة رجل you put an alif al-lam in there it makes it معرف right and it makes it known but then أسماء the alam are already معرف they're already known so why would الألف اللام and be interrelated huh this نعم so the types of the ألف اللام أما the ال is from the types is زائدة it's like the poet said رأيت الوليد ابن اليزيد مبارك بأعباء الخلافة كاهل رأيت I saw وليد ابن اليزيد وليد ابن اليزيد so this alif al lam is called is زائدة it's an additional it, meaning with its usage and taking it out and leaving it in there is the same it doesn't change anything it doesn't what change anything والعباس بن عبد المطلب وعدي بن حاتم والعلاء بن ابن الحضرمي وعتبان بن مالك وعمران بن حصين وعقبة ابن عمرو أبي مسعود الأنصاري وعقبة ابن عامر الجهني وعروة البارقي وعمار ابن ياسر وعوف ابن مالك وعمر ابن أبي سلمة وعمر ابن أمية الضمري وعمر ابن العاص وعمر ابن عوف وعويمر أبي الدرداء وعائشة بنت أبي بكر رضي الله تعالى عنهم Those are what they both agree upon, Bukhari and Muslim. وانفرد مسلم مسلم became singular on who بعتبة ابن غزوان وعياض ابن حمار المجاشعي وعمارة ابن رويبة وعويمر وعمير مولى أبي لحم وعمير مولى آن أبي لحم وعمر ابن حريث وعمر ابن حريث The correct opinion is Amr ibn Huraith is فيما اتفق عليه. Is somebody who Bukhari and Muslim both agreed upon. It's just that Bukhari, when he brought him, he didn't bring him in his what? من مسنده شيئا. He didn't bring in his musnad. Rather, he brings him in many places in the middle of the narrations. وعمر ibn أخطب وعرفجة ibn شريح وعدي ibn عميرة الكندي وعثمان ابن أبي العاص وعبد المطلب ابن ربيعة وعبد الرحمن ابن عثمان التيمي وعبد الله ابن ربيعة وعبد الله ابن السائب وعبد الله ابن الشخير وعبد الله ابن المسيب العابدي نعم عبد الرحمن ابن عثمان التيمي عبد الرحمن ابن عثمان التيمي هو mentioned Scholars, they said his name is not Abdurrahman ibn Uthman al-Taymi, rather it is what? Abdullah ibn Uthman, some said that. From those who said it was Ibn al-Jawzi in his Talqih, Ibn Abi al-Fath al-Fawaris, he also said that as well. Like in the correct is that, it's Abdurrahman ibn Uthman al-Taymi. Abdullah ibn Rabi'ah, who I already mentioned, are you there? There's no mentioning him, wala Bukhari, wala Muslim. He's not mentioned. He's no mentioning of his. And it's funny because that Ibn al-Jawzi brings that. He copies it from Dar al-Qutni. And also Abu al-Fath al-Fawaris also copies it from Dar al-Qutni. But the reality is that لَمْ أَجِدْ لَهُ فِي الصَّحِيحَيْنِ ذِكْرًا There's no mentioning of his صَحِيحَيْنِ. And nowadays, alhamdulillah, you know this software that you can just put it in and you can just double check. You can see if there is a mentioning of it, but there's no mentioning of him. And also when you read the Asanid of Sahihain, especially Darul Ta'sil right now, if you do read it, what you can do is take these names and just see if you find it in there. Whilst you're reading the Riwayat and the Asanid, you'll see that some of them are not there. Now, Abdullah ibn Shakhir and Abdullah ibn Musayyib al-Abidi. Abdullah ibn Musayyib al-Abidi, as I said, is from those who are, as Madar al-Qutni said, is from those who in which Imam Muslim is singular in narrating from. Sahih? And he's from those who are mentioned that he's a companion. Naam. Ibn Hajar says that, rahimahullah ta'ala. He says, وَهُمْ مَنْ ذَكَرَهُ فِي الصَّحَابَةِ. It's from those who are mentioned amongst the companions. But Imam Muslim, he did not bring him in his Musnad. He brings him in a what? He brings him in the riwayah of Abdullah ibn Sa'ib. He brings him inside a hadith. وَعَبْدِلَّهِ ibn Ulays, the Ansari Sahabi. It's funny because Abdullah ibn Ulays al-Ansari, his hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari, but it's mu'allaqan. So it's not Musnad. وَعَمْرِ ibn Hudayfa yukna bi-Abi Jahm. Amr ibn Hudayfa is Abi Jahm, right? Is who? Abi Jahm. Naam. There's a mention of him in Sahih al-Bukhari when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fil khamisa when he said alayhi sallam idhabu ila Abi Jahm. Go to Abi Jahm. وَعَمْرِ ibn Wathilata Abi Tufail. Naam. Very good. وانفرد البخاري بعبد الله بن زمعة. You can say زمعة if you wish to. You can say زمعة if you wish to. No, you can say عبد الله بن زمعة. You can say if you wish to. You can also say عبد الله بن زميعة if you wish to. وعبد الله بن ثعلبة بن الصعير. وعبد الله بن هشام who is a جد of زهر بن معبد. وعبد الله بن يزيد الأنصاري. And it's from those فيما اتفق عليه الشيخان. It's not right to say انفرد به البخاري. Muslim did mention him. You see, Muslim did mention him. Rather, he mentioned him من فعله موقوفا. His own action موقوفا, not مسندا. عبد الله بن يزيد الأنصاري. وعبد الرحمن أبي عبس ابن جبر. Muslim did mention him. When it came to the story of the killing of who? أبي عبس ابن جعبر كعب ابن أشرف. وأبي عامر الأشعري بخاري رحمه الله he brought him تعليقا تعليقا بصيغة الجزم الإمام البخاري رحمه الله هو أبي عامر الأشعري الإمام البخاري رحمه الله he brought him in his صحيح تعليقا and when he did bring him he brought him doubting was it from him or was it from أبي مالك الأشعري who is it from of the two واسمه his name is what عبيد ويقال عمر وأبي عبيدة ابن جراح عامر ابن عبد الله أبي عبيدة ابن جراح عامر ابن عبد الله his name is بخاري narrated from him so did Muslim رحمه الله but Imam al-Bukhari did not bring him من مسنده he did not bring him in his مسند and he didn't bring any of his روايات whatsoever He only mentioned him in the middle of a hadith. وَبِي عُقْبَ بْنُ الْحَارِثِ وَبِي عَمْرِ بْنُ تَغْلِبِ وَأَبِي رَجَاءِ عِمْرَانِ الْعُطَارِدِ And he's a what? مُخْضَرِم. مُخْضَرَم. A مُخْضَرَم is a person who lived what? Between what? He's a person that لم تثبت له الصحبة. He's not a companion, but he lived at the time of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And with that, Imam al-Darqutni rahimahullah himself, he considered him from the tabi'in who are thiqat mimman sahhat riwayatuhu fi sahihayni. The reason why he mentioned here him is because Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, there's a narration of his in which he attributed him to the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he's not a companion. He lived at the time of the Prophet, but he didn't see the Prophet. وَعَمْرِ ibn Salimah al-Jarmi. And who? Amr ibn Salimah al-Jarmi. Wa Amr ibn al-Harith ibn al-Mustaliq. Before I move on, Amr ibn Salimah al-Jarmi, Bukhari rahimahullah did not bring him in his Musnad shay, whatsoever. His riwayah is from his father. Na'am. Wa Amr ibn al-Harith ibn Mustaliq. And the truth of the matter is, Amr ibn al-Harith ibn al-Mustaliq, he is what fi mattafaqa fihi. They both agreed upon it, Bukhari al-Muslim. And al-Bukhari who narrated from him, I'm not 100% sure on that one, but there might be a chance that I'm wrong. وَعَاصِبُ الْمُثَابِتِ إِبْنُ الْأَقْلَحِ نعم. And Imam Bukhari rahimahullah did not narrate from him in his Musnad, and not any of his riwayat. Rather, he mentions in the middle of the riwayah of Abu Hurairah, the qissatu of the Asr Quraysh, when Quraysh was taken, the captive of Quraysh. That's where he was mentioned, Asim ibn Thabit, because he was from there. He was from the captives that were taken from there, from Quraysh. Wal Ada ibn Khalid, and Ada ibn Khalid, Imam al-Bukhari brought him ta'liqun hadithun bila isnad. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah brought him ta'liqan without any chain and for him. We'll conclude there inshallah ta'ala, and we'll finish it off tomorrow bi'idhnillah al-kareem, the others. It shouldn't be long. Bi'idhnillah al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِئَانِ مِنْ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ